Namaste. Bhagavad Gita has inspirations to change our life. Is death a journey to oblivion? Not just humans. We notice that all beings want to live and not die. But death happens. Sloka 22 from chapter 2 explains what death exactly means. Vasansi jirnani yatha vihaya navani grunhati naroparani tatha sharirani vihaya jirnanyanyani sanyati navani dehi. As a person sheds worn out garments and wears new ones, likewise, at the time of death, the soul casts off its worn out body and enters a new one. Have you watched the movie A Dog's Purpose? Or the famous Shah Rukh Khan's blockbuster Om Shanti Om? Both of these movies deal with the topic of reincarnation. In Om Shanti Om, a struggling junior artist who dreams of being a star becomes one in his next life. Om Kapoor, or OK, the star now, exhibits a birthmark similar to the struggling junior artist. And importantly, because of the incident where Shah Rukh Khan tries to save Deepika Padukone, when Arjun Rampal sets fire to the sets, OK, the star exhibits pyromania, fear of fire. Bhagavan Krishna asks us to change our perspective about death. Death happens to the body, not to the mind. The mind that is constituted by our thoughts, ideas, emotions, desires, likes, dislikes, leaves the body to go find a new one. The process is very similar to us changing worn out, soiled clothes. Don't we wear new ones? Do not make the mistake that we bring nothing to this world when we are born and take nothing with us when we die. We are born with our mind, importantly, and it is our responsibility to die with a refined, cultured, and better mind that is capable of understanding the reality of this universe and our own self. This shloka is a hint that mind survives death. Isn't it mind-blowing? If mind is the only thing that survives death, let us choose to spend the only currency we have, our time in this life, wisely to cultivate our minds. This is powerful insight, shattering myths and fear about death. Hari Om.